Before I go any further, I would like to say a few words of some people I've known and particularly appreciated. I've met many great men in my life. I mentioned von Neumann, with whom I did my postdoc, and I could mention many others. But two I would like to mention are not known the same way, in particular Marcel-Paul Schützenberger. When I was writing my PhD in 1952, which I defend in 1952, about a year before, I met a man in Paris at Henri Poincaré Institute after a seminar he gave. We went, I was very impressed by his seminar, went to have beer together, and then went to have dinner together, then we had chat together. Then about 5 a.m. of the next day, we left each other and saw each other again next day, then a month later, and so on. He died 2 years ago. For this long period, we had, perhaps one could say, a single conversation going on and interrupted sometimes for a day, sometimes for a month, sometimes for many years. Why did Schützenberger like me? Why did I like him? Well, there are many reasons one cannot understand, but one reason linked us very strongly, that he too could not make up his mind about who he was and what field he was in. He happened to have studied medicine and got the medical degree during the war, but also studied mathematics and got in due time a PhD in mathematics, and studied many things. In his idle time, he was studying Hungarian, because why study easy language if there's the hard ones? But almost always, when I had started working on some exotic field which nobody cared, I was sure that Marco, as we all called him, would be find it fun and make some ferocious comments about how terrible and marvelous and awful and wonderful it was. He was my worst critic, more precisely my most critical critic, and my best friend. A difference between his work and mine is that his work remained, scattered over many fields. He contributed to that field, that other field, without even attempting to draw a link between his various activities. After he died, I realized that he had had many passions which he never shared with me, because he thought I would not be interested. That is, I knew only one side or five sides of the many other sides of this man. I, to the contrary, always wanted my different interests to come together, because I always felt them to be one aspect of the same story.